Hey guys, what's going on and welcome or welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be doing a lip swatch and a review of the newly launched Huda Beauty's Mini Power Bullet Kits. Now they have come out with two kits and I have both of them, which is their Power Nudes and their Power Reds. Now, I do not know why, very recently I realized that I do not own any of the Huda Beauty lip products. I do have their eyeshadow palettes, which I love, as well as their foundation. But in lip products, I do not own any of them. I do not know why. So these are the first time I ever own any Huda Beauty lipsticks. And yeah, I just thought I'll mention that. I don't know why, but yeah. So coming back to the video, for foundation shade reference, I'm NC40 in MAC, and in Maybelline I'm 310 Sun Beige. Now before we can get into the description, the lip swatches, the pros and cons, because I have some thoughts about these, do not forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it to notify whenever I upload. And now let's jump right in the video. So like I mentioned before, they have come out with two kits. The first one is Power Nudes, which have the shade Interview and Girls Trip. And then they have the Power Reds, which is El Cinco de Mayo and Promotion Day. Now these are priced at 1,550 rupees and each of their products is about 0.9 grams. So this is the Power Nudes kit, where you have the shade Girls Trip and this is the shade Interview. Just one thing to note is the cap is not magnetic, but it closes pretty tightly. And this is the Power Reds kit, wherein the brighter red shade is El Cinco de Mayo and the darker red shade is Promotion Day. And this is how the actual lipstick looks like. And now let's finally move on to the lip swatches. Alright, so let's talk about the formula of these lipsticks. Now firstly, these are super creamy. I love the texture. It glides so smooth like butter and it feels so comfortable on the lips. It doesn't feel like you're wearing any lipstick at all, and it is not drying or anything of that sort. It's just the right amount of moisturization on your lips, which is perfect. Now these do set to a matte finish and they feel kind of powdery or creamy on the lips. Now these are super pigmented. Just one layer is more than sufficient to cover your whole lips. Now these are not transfer proof. Now I've already been wearing this for like about 2 to 3 hours, and as you guys can see, it still looks pretty good. Like the top layer has come off, but I'll just show you a quick example. There is a very, very slight transfer, and that is because I had like water, coffee and a little bit of snacks, and at that time the top layer kind of came off. This is just what it is left over, but even then it still looks great on my lips. Now these do last for quite a long time. Like I wore it for about like 6 hours and then I had to eat, but until then it was absolutely fine. And this is how it looks like once you have a very heavy meal. Now I was wearing the shade Promotion Day, and as you guys can see, if I just rub my lips together, I can get like a sheer color of the original shade, but I'm good to go. However, when it comes to nude shades, you would have to reapply because it will just not be visible. And the removal of these lipsticks is quite easy. You can just use a wet wipe and it easily comes off. And last but not the least, these do smell amazing. They smell really good. For me, it's like an added bonus if a lipstick smells good. So yeah, those were the pros. And now just a quick FYI, because personally for me it's not a con, but I just want to let you guys know, because for some of them it could be, is the sizing or the quantity of the product. Now this has only 0.9 grams of product, which is quite less for each lipstick, and it is quite pricey. For me, in my head, it justifies because it's a luxury brand, it's not like an affordable brand, so I get it. But yeah, that's why I want to mention it as an FYI, is the quantity of the product is quite less compared to the pricing. And now coming to the cons, the first con is to do with the shades, especially the shade which is Power Nudes. Now this kit, which is the nude shades, Girl Strip and Interview. Now if you're a fair skin tone, it's going to suit you absolutely fine. There's not going to be any issue at all. However, if you're a medium skin tone like me, or someone with a darker skin tone or really dark skin tone, it is not going to suit you if you're going to use it like a standalone lipsticks, because without the help of a lip liner or mixing it with another lipstick, it will kind of wash you off. For me itself, the shade which is Girl Strip completely washed me off, which is a lighter shade, and the shade Interview, which is supposed to be a bit more darker than Girl Strip, that as well kind of washed me off. So I would have to use it with a lip liner or mix it with another lipstick for me to be satisfied the way how it looks on my skin tone. I hope that's making sense. Like for example, right now I have mixed the shade Interview along with the El Cinco de Mayo shade, and this is how pretty it looks like, but then I had to mix it. So yeah, that is the first con, is that if you are like a medium or a medium dark skin tone or darker skin tone, it may not suit you, it will kind of wash you off. So yeah, choose wisely. Now in the same con is the Power Reds, because both the reds kind of look similar. El Cinco de Mayo is a little bit like a brighter red, and Promotion Day is a darker red, but it does look quite similar. There's very teeny tiny bit of difference. So I wish there was like another shade over there, like I don't know, some maroonish or darker shade, which would have looked good, I guess. So yeah, that is the other con in this first con. Now for the second con, I kind of wish that a consumer could actually choose the shade that will go in the kit. Like if they had all the four options and you can make like a kit yourself, that would have been great, because I would have personally chosen the shade Interview because I can mix it, it looks good once it's mixed, and just one of the reds. Or the best thing would have been if this was sold individually. So that's just the second con that I had. That's just a personal opinion though, but yeah. The last con, which is not like a deal breaker, but I really wish that they had like more shades or more kits to choose from. Overall, in my opinion, when it comes to the formula, the longevity, the comfort, the pigmentation, it is excellent. The formula is amazing and it is A++. And if you are planning to buy like the full size version of it, this is a great way for you to test and see how these feel and also look like. However, when it comes to shades, if you're a fairer skin tone, both the lip kits will look amazing on you. You have no issues or no problems at all. However, if you are medium skin tone or a darker skin tone, then you will have to use the help of like a lip liner or mix it with another lipstick for the Power Nudes. And for the Power Reds, no matter what your skin tone is, it is gonna look amazing. So yeah guys, these were my thoughts on the Huda Beauty's mini power bullet kits, and this wraps up today's video, you guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, do not forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon right next to it so that you're notified whenever I upload, as well as like the video and comment down below. If you have any questions or requests, I will try my best for you, as well as follow me on my socials, which is Ishtanair on Instagram and Ishtanair on Twitter as well. So until the next time, take care. Bye. Thank you.